president demands housing sector reform, supports AbdulRazaq's clear called developmental plans for Kwara, Salahu charges stakeholders, ministries to curb human trafficking migration, labor threatens indefinite strike gives 1 week ultimatum, Wike moves to sanitise Abuja land administration, UNICEF says more than 330 million children in extreme poverty globally. Police nab NDLEA, NSCDC officers over alleged extortion in Imo and on sport. Nigerian referees ignored as CAF unveils 85 for 2023 AFCON. Servants and captains of industries have been urged to team up with Kwara State Governor AbdulRazaq to bring his economic and developmental agenda for the state to fruition. A media guru and fellow of the Nigeria Institute of Public Relations, Alhaji Sadu Salahu, made the appeal at a forum organized by the Media Town Hall held in Ilorin. Salahu will speak on the topic, Kwara development, the role of stakeholders, expressed delight on Governor AbdulRazaq's outstanding leadership initiatives and visions. He noted that the state's plans aligns with the 2030 Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations, African Union, and several international and development partners. The guest speaker proceeded that a critical examination of Governor AbdulRazaq's leadership vision, policy agenda and implementation has put Kwara on the global map as one of the best governed states in Africa in the past 4 years. The event was graced by Mr. Shegun Adeyemi, Associate Professor Sauda Sala Abubaki, Chairperson Dr. Abdulhamid Badmus, guest of honor, Alhaji Kuranga Idowu Omomeji, distinguished guest, and Prince Olayemi Adrotoyi, among others. The Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs and Poverty Alleviation has said it will partner Ministry of Interior to tackle internal security, human trafficking, migration, others. The minister, Dr. Meta Edu, also said she will end the mystery of Nigerians caught up in poverty and humanitarian needs. The collaboration between the ministries, according to her, was imperative due to President Bola Tinubu's desire to address humanitarian crises and lift Nigerians from the global poverty index in line with the Renewed Hope agenda of his government. The Nigeria Labour Congress on Tuesday threatened to begin an indefinite strike should the federal government fail to meet its demands at the end of 21-day ultimatum, which will expire in approximately 1 week. The workers' union said the proposed strike was necessary following the failure of the federal government to provide palliatives to assuage the Nigerians' hardships as a result of forced subsidy removal. The Nigerian Labour Congress said the industrial action, which may commence any day from next week, will lead to an indefinite shutdown of commercial and economic activities across the country. The Federal Capital Territory Minister, Yasom Wike, has warned that those involved in illegal land transactions in Abuja would henceforth have a rough The minister gave the warning at the inauguration of FCTA mandate secretaries. The secretaries are the pal with commissioners in the state. The United Nations Children's Fund has said 333 million children are still living in extreme poverty globally. The report from UNICEF and the World Bank indicates that the COVID-19 pandemic led to the abolition of extreme poverty for 30 million fewer Nigerians than was previously predicted. The Imo State Police Command has nabbed three officers of the National Drug Law Enforcement Agencies and two from the Nigeria Security and Civil Defense Corps for allegedly harassing and extorting civilians in that state. The spokesman for the command, the ASP Henry Okoye, made this known to newsmen on Tuesday in Owerri. He alleged that the suspects were notorious for extorting unsuspecting civilians, especially the youth in Owerri, using point-of-sale machines. The last on the news is sport. The Confederation of African Football has listed 85 referees for a preparatory course ahead of the 2023 Africa Cup of Nations. However, no Nigerian referees made the shortlist reviewed by CAF yesterday. The list includes center referees, assistant referees, video assistant referees, technical instructors, physical trainers, VAR technicians, and IT support. Supports AbdulRazaq's clear-cut developmental plans for Kwara, Salahu child stakeholders. Ministries to curb human trafficking, migration. Labour threatens indefinite strike, gives 1 week ultimatum. Wike moves to sanitise Abuja land administration. UNICEF says more than 330 million children in extreme poverty globally. Police nab NDLEA, NSCDC officers over alleged extortion in Imo and sport. Nigerian referees ignored as CAF unveils 85 for 2023 AFCON. Thank you for watching Just Event Online News. Remember, is teaching time saves 9. For more news, visit www.justeventonline.com and to read more updates, follow us on our social media platforms with a tap at Just Event Online. You can also send us an email on justeventonline@gmail.com. I am Anifat Ismail. Do have a good night.